Well, protests turned violent in Puerto Rico as people filled the streets to oppose the austerity measures. Almost 20 people have been arrested, more than a dozen police officers hurt, and countless protesters injured. Today's reporter Bianca Grollo spoke to a man who was covering the strike, and he got caught in the scuffle.
You're looking at Puerto Rican demonstrators desperately trying to escape after police fire tear gas at the crowd. Gilberto Vasquez Gomez recorded this video.
I was basically trapped. Me and a lot of hundreds of people, we were basically trapped and breathing this thing.
He was there as a photojournalist, but in that moment, he was just another person trying to get out.
Were you scared?
I really thought that I was going to die. And it might sound exaggerating, but it's not. I couldn't breathe at all. I was like trying, and the people were not moving because there were a lot. There were hundreds and hundreds of people. So I started to do what I needed to do to get out of there. So I started to go on top of people.
The strike was to protest the closing of schools, university tuition increases, and potential cuts to benefits. A lot of the discontent was directed at a federal control board that oversees the island's finances.
A space to protest and to bring alternative proposals is always welcome.
Yesterday, the governor condemned the violence.
What happens is when it turns to violence.
Gilberto says he saw protesters throwing rocks at police, but thinks the officers went too far.
I think it was excessive.
And he says he understands the outrage.
We're taking everything from the people. Ah! I don't want to justify violence, but people are desperate. If they're hungry, if they're desperate, if they feel hopeless, what else can they do?
And you feel like they're not being heard?
Nah, we're not being heard.
The Puerto Rican government is shutting down 280 schools this summer.